I would like to congratulate the Digital India team on the auspicious day to celebrate completion of 5 years of Digital India program. Today, in middle of pandemic, this event is being organized in a digital manner. I believe no other way to celebrate this 5 year completion of Digital India program would have been better. In these times of pandemic, the only mode of effective and safe communication available is digital communication, and our Ministry of Electronics and IT has been ensuring through its digital that communication and safe for common citizen. In the fight against COVID-19, these initiatives such as direct benefit transfer, e-office, video conferencing system, mobile services through Umang app, digital services through DigiLocker, etc., telecommunication have demonstrated usefulness of Digital India. Digital initiatives have played an important role for India, while we continue to work towards our goals amid restrictions owing to lockdown 1 to 4. Information technologies, beyond doubt, served as blessing in disguise. During the course of journey, Digital India has been successful in establishing world-class digital infrastructure, new digital services, service delivery models, and has become the role model of digital empowerment and social function in the world, worth copying by any country in the world. As a part of digital infrastructure, Aadhaar is world's largest biometric and demographic-based authentication platform in the world. Unified Payment Interface, UPI, is again a digital payment leader in the country, facilitating 150+ banks to offer payment facilities seamlessly. The digital endeavor has always been logical and focusing on the needs of a common man. This proved to be foundation Jam Trinity in India. Jan Dhan account, Aadhaar, and mobile has been helping in governments to ensure direct monetary benefit is transferred hassle-free to the beneficiaries. Digital empowerment was and is the main purpose of Digital India. Every citizen, government employee, and business should derive power and benefits from Digital India. On this front, my government platform is facilitating both Mann Ki Baat by Honorable Prime Minister and Jan Ki Baat. The central government has facilitated a dashboard-based monitoring in all ministries, departments, which makes available scheme-wise and time series-wise progress detail for public knowledge. GIS-based decision support are being used for data-driven decision-making. Majority of Indian population and the soul of India resides in its villages. Therefore, Digital India is sure to take the fruits of e-governance to our brothers and sisters living in the villages. Common service centers are making available government services through their village-level entrepreneurs network spread across the country. Garib Kalyan Rozgar Abhiyan has been launched by our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Bhai Modi ji on June 20, 2020 to boost livelihood opportunities in the rural India. A total of 116 districts, including 27 aspirational districts, will be direct beneficiaries. 12 ministries, department will implement it in a coordinated manner. The initiative will be accelerated through Digital India initiatives that includes building telecom infrastructure and easing digital monitoring tools such as direct benefit transfers. GIS-based project progress monitoring system, etc. As a part of Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan, digital education, digital healthcare, digital agriculture, etc. have been emphasized in detail. The recent online auction of coal mines and past online auction of telecom spectrum has demonstrated the clear intent of government to support economic development without any compromise on transparency. The recently launched three schemes of electronics manufacturing schemes by our ministry should be tapped by the private sector to establish the manufacturing units in India, either on their own or in collaboration with global MNCs, so as to establish India as the hub of electronics manufacturing in the world. In today's times, a nation is strong if its technology base is strong. Indian talent is known worldwide in software. Times has come such that the talent coupled with technologies lead to global products from India for India and for the world. Next leap of digital India must focus on emerging technologies like artificial intelligence, machine learning, etc. At last, I would like to sum up that digital India has delivered a strong foundation. The upcoming futures looks even brighter when we benchmark ourselves with global best practices and rising aspirations from our citizens who dream to get services in self-service mode, who dream to get administrative approval within few months, few days, and not few months. Exports want to ship out the deliveries quickly and competitively, that is within hours and maximum few days, with accurate prediction of transportation and logistics. All these aspirations are being factored in the next vision of Digital India as new national public digital platform, which will be rolled out in social sectors such as health, agriculture, education, justice, etc., and strategic sectors such as logistics, lands, land record. I wish all the best to Team India, which consists of government, industries, academia. I am sure we will continue to work with stronger collaboration and more vigor to digitally realize the aspirations of our citizens and to digitally implement the call of our Honorable Prime Minister on Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan.